Hello guys, in today's video I'll be telling you about the tonal resolution, and we will see how can we basically get a look of this tonal resolution with the help of MATLAB. So what does tonal resolution basically mean? Tonal resolution basically is analogous to quantization. Now what is quantization? Quantization is basically how many colors you can put in your image. So if suppose that that is basically related to number of bits. Generally we use 8 bits for a pixel. So one pixel, we are talking about grayscale images over here. So we use 8 bits for one particular pixel. Hence, we basically one pixel can be represented by 8 bits. So therefore, the color range that we have goes from 0 to 2 raised to 8 minus 1, that is 0 to 255. So basically, I have this wide range of 256 colors that I can use. All zeros, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. These will represent basically black color, and all ones, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, will represent black color. Oh, sorry, white color. So this is all about tonal resolution when I am talking about 8 bits. Now suppose I want a 6 bit or 4 bit image. Say consider a 4 bit image. So when I consider a 4 bit image, my combinations reduce, because now it will be 2 raised to 4. Now it will be 2 raised to 4. That is basically 16. So I will have my color range from 0 to 15. So now I will have only 16 colors with me. So now where I was getting a wide range of 256 colors, now I will just have 16 colors with me. So this is tonal resolution. If I take suppose one bit, so one bit means only 0 or 1, that only two values, 0 or 1. So I just have two colors, that is black and white, just pure two colors, black and white. So this is what we are going to see. How does this matter? How does this change the look of the image that we are going to see? So what basic approach will be that we have an image. So basically say consider this is an image, the given image consider. So this will have basically 8 bits. Consider a 3x3 image. So this will have 8 bits. So if suppose this is so this the pixels in this will range from 0 to 255. So one value can be 255, one value can be 0, say 100, 90, let others be 0. So consider suppose this is the given image. So now to convert this to what we call these different types of images, what we have to do is, first we'll have to consider I am taking this pixel. So 255, 8 bit, this is the 8 bit value. If I want to convert it to a say 4 bit value, what will I have to do? I'll have to convert this to binary. So 255 in binary is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 ones. Now, if I want to convert this to 4 bit, what I do? I consider only the first 4. If this is the MSB and this is the LSB, I consider only the first 4 bits. That will give me 4 bit image. So basically these 4 bits, 1, 2, 3, 4, that will give me a 4 bit image. Let's consider 100. So suppose 100 in binary, so 100 in binary will be represented as this is 10, in binary it will be represented as 1100100. So if suppose I want to convert this to 4 bit, I will just take the first 4 digits, so that will be 1100. This is my 4 bit image, so the first 4. If I want to consider 2 bits, then I will take the first 2 bits. So that is the main logic over here that we are going to use. We will take the image, we will convert each of these values into their equivalent binary first. Then we will only take the first 4 bits if we want the 4 bit image. We will only take 2 bits for 2 bit image. And similarly, and if we want a 1 bit image, we will just take the first bit. So that is the logic about converting an 8 bit image to corresponding 4 bit or 2 bit image. Okay, one more thing that we'll have to see, which is important, is MATLAB. I have talked about uint 8 data type. So this is the data type that MATLAB uses. Now we have other data types, that is uint 32, uint 16. So basically here uint 8 means 8 bit. So uint 32 will mean 32 bit and 16 will be 16 bit. But we don't have any data type that is uint 4 or uint 2. So I have explained what is uint 8 data type in my video. If you have not seen that video, please go through that video once, so you will understand what I am trying to say in a couple of minutes from now. So what I basically want to say is, in uint 8 we have seen, when we use imshow, it converts each pixel that is 0 to white. Sorry, each pixel that is 0 to black, and each pixel that is 255 to white. This is what happens in imshow when we use uint 8 with imshow. Now we are always going to use this data type, that is uint 8. But if suppose consider a 1 bit image, so when we get the output, when we will basically take this, convert into binary and take the first bits only, so what will happen is we will get an image that is something like this: 0101001011, something like this. So it will just have values 0 and 1. But now there is a problem. If I directly use this particular image and do imshow on it, it will consider 0 as black. Now 1 will also be black because it has this wide range. So for uint 8, 0 is also black and 1 is also black. So this is a problem. You will get a black image. So in order to remove this problem, what you want? You want 0 to be 0, but 1 to be 255, because you want 1 to be pure white. So here the significance of 1 is pure white. So therefore what you'll have to do, you'll have to multiply this image by 255. When you multiply the image by 255, what happens is this will become 0, this 1 will get converted to 255, 0, 1 to 255, 0, 255, 255, 255, and 255. So this is what we want. Now when you take the imshow of this image, it will give you the desired image. Similarly, when you are working with 4 bit image, the maximum value will be 15, because the range is from 0 to 2 raised to 4 minus 1, that is 0 to 15. So here you will have some values like 0, 7, 15, etc. So here the important thing is, you want 15 to be equal to 255. Here 0 should be black and 15 should be basically 255, so that you can map it into this range of colors. So therefore you will have to multiply this by 255 divided by 15 basically. So that comes out to be 17. So you will have to multiply a 4-bit image by 17 so that the maximum value becomes 255 and the other values will be managed accordingly. Similarly, for a 2-bit image, the maximum value ranges from 0 to 2 raised to 2, that is minus 1, that is from 0 to 3. So you will have to multiply by 2 raised to 255 by 3. So 3 ones are 3, 85s are. So you will have to multiply by 85 for a 2-bit image. So these numbers are important. From where did I get this number? This is basically 255 upon the number, the maximum number of that particular image. So if it is a 2-bit image, the 3 will be the maximum pixel value. So you divide by that number and you will get this. Now this is only for MATLAB, because MATLAB uses this data type that is used in IMShow. So this is the basics. Let us start coding. Okay, let us see how will the code will be. First, our usual notations: CLC, clear, close. Next, let me define a variable, say capital A this time. That is IMRead. I will have my image over here. This will be cameraman.tif. Oops, only one M. So that is cameraman.tif. Don't forget the semicolon. Next, let me get its size. So let M comma N. Please see I am using square brackets over here, as it is an array. Next, this will be size of capital A this time, semicolon. So here I've got the size of A. So now I want to basically extract all the elements of A and convert them into binary. So for extracting all that, we'll need a for loop. So let for I go from first element. This I will represent the rows of the image basically. So the first row till the last row. So the last row will be given by M. Next, for J. So J will be equal to, it'll go from the first column to the last column. So the last column is N. Now what do we actually want? So we'll first take what is the pixel value. So the pixel value, let me denote it by a small variable A. So the pixel value will be basically capital A of I comma J. So when I and J both are 1, this will give me A of 1 comma 1. So that will tell me the first pixel of the particular image. When J will be 2, it will tell me the second pixel. So A is basically taking all the pixel values one by one. So that is A basically. Next, I'll have to convert this into binary. Now this is the decimal format. I have to convert it into binary. So let me take a variable B. Now to convert it into binary, there is a simple function, and that function is decimal to binary. So DEC to bin. This will convert your given function into binary. So now it has some inputs that you have to give. First input is what number you want to convert. So I want to convert this number. And next is in how many bits. So now I want, now this has to be first converted into 8 bits, because that is basically 0 to 255. My original image is 8 bits. Hence I am writing 8 over here. So I will get the 8 bit output. So this I have successfully converted the given image into a binary that was originally 8 bit. Next, if I want say 4-bit image, what will I do? I'll take a variable C, and I will only take the first 4 values of B, because I told you the MSB, the first 4 numbers from the MSB are the values that we want for say 4-bit. So this will be for 4-bit. Let me write some comment. This will give me the 4-bit value. Okay, this is not actually necessary in your code, that is just for you can understand that this is for 4-bit. Similarly, say if I want D, so D will be, say I want 2-bit. So 2-bit I'll range only from 1 to 2. So that will give me a 2-bit image. Next, suppose I want a 1-bit image. So for 1-bit image, you just want the first MSB bit, so you'll take B of 1. So that is important over here. Also, don't forget to put semicolons, or there'll be a wide range of numbers that'll be rolling in your command window, which will be very annoying. So this is it. Next, you now want an image. These are just values. You'll have to actually create an image matrix out of it. So to create the image matrix, I'll use capital letters. So C of I comma J. Now C of I comma J will basically make a matrix that is a 2D array. Now these are not 2D arrays. These are numbers, scalar numbers, A, B, C, D, because I have not put IJ over here. So these are 2D arrays. Also notice I have put round brackets over here, because this is what we call, I am denoting a particular value in the matrix. So denotation of a matrix is done in square brackets. Here I am not denoting anything. Here this is an array. The size output is given to this particular array. Hence this is round brackets. Also you can remember like this, if there is something A of something, yeah, C of something, there will be square brackets. If the brackets are alone, here there is no A, B, C, there is empty thing. So here there will be square brackets. That way also you can remember. So now C of I comma J. So C of I comma J, what will be? It will be basically, you will have to convert this back to decimal. So this you'll have to convert it to back to decimal. So what I for that you have the function bind to decimal. So you first had function decimal to binary, now you'll do binary to decimal. And what input you will give is basically small c, because small c has the characters, the binary 4-bit value that you want to make, convert it into decimal. Similarly, capital D of I comma J will be equal to bind to decimal D. Next, similarly, capital E of I comma J will be bind to decimal of small e. So these are the so by this you will get four images C, D, E. That will be important. That will be basically showing you the 4-bit, 2-bit and 1-bit. Okay, this is a 1-bit value. 1-bit value. So these are all values, and over here you will get the image. So here you will get a 4-bit image. Here you will get a 2-bit image. And here you will get a 1-bit image. So that's all for the for loop. Let us end the for loops. Next, you want to show the image. So first let me show the original image. So for that I'll use imshow. The original image was stored in A. So therefore imshow A, capital A. Let me give it a title, that is original image. Next, the second is imshow, let's say 4-bit image. So the 4-bit image is stored in C. You can see over here the C variable. So that'll be C. But important thing before this will be that you'll have to multiply it by that particular factor. So that factor is basically, let me take C, capital C will be first multiplied by capital C. Now since this is a 4-bit image, you will have to multiply it by 17. So please remember this. After this, you will do IM show capital C, and let the title be 4-bit image. So the title will be 4-bit image. Next, you want something similar to this. Oops. So here you will have D, here you will have D, here the number will change. For D, the number is basically 85. So here, or else if you don't remember, you can do 255 divided by the number of the maximum number. So for 4-bit image, for 2-bit image, the maximum number is 3, so that is 255 divided by 3. That will give you 85. But this is the main logic for that, for those numbers. Next, E. So E, let me paste that again. So this will be 2-bit image. Oh, you'll have to change this also. And here let me put E. Okay, so let me put a figure window so that all are distinctly visible. So here you'll have E, I am show E, and here there'll be 255 by 1, that is basically 255. And this is a 1-bit image. Let us run and see what happens. So this is the plot that we are getting. This is the original image. Also, the other thing to notice is all these images E, C and D that we are showing, these all are double. I have always told you to always use uint8 data type when you are doing IM show particular thing. Hence, it is very important to convert all of these to uint8. That was the reason we were getting the undesirable image. So hence it is very necessary to convert this to uint8 and then run the code. So that is very important over here. Yes, this is the required output. So here you can see this is the original image, this is the 4-bit image, this is the 2-bit image. Oops. The 2-bit image, and this is the 1-bit image. So you can see the difference. Here you can see this color is very this image is very smooth. Here the color combination, everything is very sharp and very nice. Here you can see the difference. You can see this is something of like a patchwork over here. So here there is a patch that you can see, and you can differentiate between the regions over here. Here differentiating between the regions is not that easy. If you see over here, this region has become totally flat. All the colors in this region are same. There is no shading that is available over here. There is no shading over here. You can see in this image, this is perfectly black and white image. There is no gray color that is available to us. So this is the main importance of tonal resolution. You can see that this is an image where you can have a different shades of gray. So here there are the different shades of gray. If you notice, this shade of gray is totally gone in this image. So there is no pillar that is seen in this image. If you see the black and white, there is actually nothing that can be seen over here. So this is the main difference between the all the 4-bit image, 2-bit image and 1-bit image. So these techniques are very useful in compressing the images. So you can compress accordingly how many bits you want and how much information is required. Thank you so much for watching to my video. I hope you liked my video. Please subscribe. I am going to upload more videos of these kinds. And stay tuned to the channel. Thank you so much.